In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create an ugly Christmas sweater design like this one right here, and you can do lots more using elements from Canva. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to show you a design style that's super popular during this time, and that is the ugly Christmas t-shirt or ugly Christmas sweater t-shirt designs. Now, I did a video like this before about a year ago, this one right here, and I did it all in Affinity Designer. This time I'm gonna show you how to do it in Canva, mainly using Canva Pro, but there's some free Canva stuff that you can use as well. Lots to do there. I wanted to show you before that how popular this is. So here it is on Amazon. Take a look, I'm using Pretty Merch Pro to look at the BSRs, and look at these super low BSRs, right? They sell a lot during this time because people wanna wear these kinds of t-shirts for Christmas and the holidays. Also on Redbubble, you can do a search. You can do this search yourself doing ugly Christmas sweater designs. Look at all the results here. And they also sent me an email that I got. Look at this. They're actually pushing this ugly Christmas sweater designs on Redbubble. So you know it's super popular for them, which means it's going to be super popular for us as well. So I'm going to show you how to do it all in Canva. And I'm gonna take you step by step on how to do it and what kinds of things to look for so that you can make more and more of these. There's not only one way to do it, there's lots of different ways to do it. The best thing to do is find a good phrase, like a pun, and maybe something funny. I think funny, ugly Christmas sweater t-shirts do really well on there. So find a funny phrase, think of a funny phrase, and then we're gonna work from there. I have my own funny phrase, so I'm gonna use that in this tutorial. So let's get into Canva right now and get started. So here we are on Canva, canva.com. You can see I'm on the home page. The first thing you're gonna do is just wanna start a design, create a design. So let's do that. Create a design, custom size. I'm using 4,500 by 5,400. You can type that in here, but I already have mine. So I'm gonna click on that. And then I'm gonna color the background red just because most of the ugly t-shirt sweaters designs are on a red t-shirt. They don't have to be, they can be on green or black or whatever, but this is how you color it red. Just come in here and just pick red. Boom. Now it can be a darker red or whatever, but I think this red will be fine. If you want to make it darker, you can come in here, and then just pull this down a little bit like that, right? So we're gonna, whatever color red you're gonna use, that's fine. That's the first step. Of course, you should have your phrase already. I'm gonna show you my phrase that I'm gonna use, but it can be whatever. In fact, it doesn't have to be a phrase. You saw some of those examples that just had pictures on it, like a pug or something funny, maybe a reindeer or a dinosaur or whatever it is. You don't actually have to have words, but if you're gonna use words, I think that's the easiest way to do something funny. So let's go in here and let's find some text. So the first thing I'm gonna do is go to Elements and type in knit design. So knit sweater design is kind of what we're going for. It doesn't have to actually be knit, but I'll show you what I mean. Knit designs. And I'm just gonna go to graphics. And right away you're gonna see there's letters here. Now this is just for the pro version, but I'm gonna show you what it looks like. You can see it looks like a knit sweater, and you can change this to white, right? Now if you don't have the pro version, what I would suggest is to just type, use some font. So I'm gonna hit T right here. And you can see this is just a regular text. And I'm gonna go in here and type in Christmas. Now it's not gonna bring up the same kind of font, but you're gonna see there's some cool fonts that you can use for Christmas. Let me show you. Let me just make this white so we have the same color here. And then let's see what other ones we have. That one's kind of cool. This one's kind of neat. You see, again, they're not very like knit sweater, but I think this one's pretty cool too. So you're not gonna get the exact same thing for free. Oh, this one is actually a pro. Let me see. I wasn't looking. So this one's free. This one's free. What another thing you could do is go to Pixel. So I'm gonna do Pixel. Here's some Pixel fonts that kind of look like this, like. This one you could use, right? It looks kind of like pixelated like a sweater, and that's free, Arcade Gamer. This one is free. That one's free. Let me see another one that I like here. Yeah, that one's not bad. So you can see, you can use some of the kind of the pixelated ones text for free if you don't have the pro version to use the knitted sweater. But I'm gonna use the knitted sweater in this example. So use what you want there. So the way I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna spell a word. So let me show you how I'm gonna do that. I'm just gonna do a short word and then you can see, I'll show you how it looks like after. So we come in here and do see all, and my phrase that I'm gonna use is, it's not ugly, it's festive. Something like that. So I just came up with that ugly Christmas sweater, right? So I'm gonna use the I here, and then we got a T here. And they don't have an apostrophe, but I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do. So we have the crop tool. Okay. And then create this white, right? White, whoops. Make sure they're all the same size. You can see it kind of snaps to it on this kind of a grid. And I need an apostrophe here. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use that exclamation point here, but only the bottom part of it. But let's make sure it's the same height. Boom. And then the crop tool. Boom. Done. And then color it. Wait. Now once you got this, you can group it all. So select all of it, hit Command G, and then now I can scale it all together. So if I need it smaller or bigger, I can do that, right? All right, so that's how you do the words. The next thing you wanna do is to find some graphics, right? To put as the border and things like that. So you can still come in here and you can do knit designs, and you'll see there's a ton of them for paid version. For free, there's not so much, so you're gonna have to kind of be creative here. I'll show you what you have for free. Apply filters here. Now, you do have things like this, but there's a background right there, so you'll have to knock out the background, which is really hard on some of these knit ones. So you're gonna wanna do something like without a background. See, that one has background. All the free ones have background, so you're gonna have to scroll down and look. Yeah, that one has a background too. You may wanna do like knit design, snowflake, and you could kind of fake it, right? So you could do like this isn't a knit design, but you could do like a border like this, right? And maybe do a top line like that. Let's see what else we got for free. It's a lot tougher for free. Yeah, see, that one has a background too. I think most of them will have backgrounds for free. Yeah, like I said, you could do the, oh, here's one. Oh, that one's kind of colorful. Maybe not that one. This one? Oh, look at that. This one is free and it's a border. So you just have to be patient and kind of go around. Let me do all white here and see what it looks like. Yeah, look at that. That's pretty cool, right? So that's free. So let me show you what else you can do when you're not free. I'm gonna take off free here, apply filters. There are going to be a lot more choices, right? So we can do something like this. Look at that. And then what you can do is, what if I did like that and then crop it? I don't want the whole thing. Crop it like that, right? So you can see where I'm going with this. I can just do that and then let's see. Let's uncrop it and then do the bottom part. So what if I did like this? And this is just one of many, right? So see that? So I'm gonna work on this. I'll show you how it is. We can find also graphics like this, like to fill the space, right? Boom. There's just tons of stuff here. Look, there's another one. Like you could make so many of these Christmas sweater ones, right? Just, I would say come up with a list of 10 different ideas, 10 different phrases, and then come in here and do 10 different ones. You can knock this out pretty quickly and give yourself a better chance of selling, right? So I'm gonna do this on the side. I'll show you what I come up with. I'm gonna spell out, you don't need to watch me spell out, it's not ugly, it's festive, right? But you can come up with your own phrase with these letters or use the fonts if you're doing it for free. And I'm gonna put it all together and I'll show you what it looks like. So we're back. You can see I put them all together. So I got It's Not Ugly, It's Festive, all using that same font that we found for knit sweater. So we can come back here and then you do knit designs, right? And like I said, there's a ton of them. Go to graphics and use the ones that don't have the background, right? So this one has a background. I wouldn't do that, but if you can come in here and find one, find some good ones in here. And if you're gonna do a lot of these, what I would suggest is come in here, hit I, and then start, right? Like see how I start it. So this can be in your bookmarks. And if you need to go back and look at it, I'll kind of put together a list of these that you can use over and over again, kind of switch them out, right? So you can come in here, like if they're too big, you know, do the crop tool. So let's do white first, and then you can come in here and do the crop tool like we did before and just crop that part out and use that as the bottom. You can see like it all works together, right? Okay, so let me show you what I did after that. So we have that top that I showed you and the bottom that I showed you, and I found these like ornaments and different things in here. One of the things that I found right here was with the knit design. So if we came in here, did that S and did C all, you'll see that we have this one right here, element, and we have this one right here, this element. So you can put these and make them smaller, right, and put them in there and kind of fit in that space. So if I didn't want this one, I could switch it out and put this, you know, right there, and it fits. It makes it look like it's a sweater, like it's knit. And what I would do is do the same thing on the other side, but flip it. So let me show you how to do that. So let's say we want this right here. We're gonna hold down Option and Shift and drag it here. And then once we get it to this side, we're gonna flip it like that and kind of eyeball it. See where it's the same here and here, right? So that just gives a nice feeling. Let's get rid of this. I did the same here. You can find so many elements. Like I did snowflake again, right? You can see a bunch of different snowflake versions of it. This would be good. So like bookmark these and use it for another one. This one's really cool, right? Things I also did, you can also do deer. So let's see. You got a bunch of deer here that are pixelated. So you got, let's see a good one. Now they don't have to be pixelated. Like this could work still in here if you wanna put it in. Everything works with Christmas sweaters, right? But if we wanna do a pixelated one, let's see if we got one here. So to help out, I changed the search to knit deer, and you can see there's a ton of them here. I'm gonna do it on another page here so you can see. Let's do another and add it here, make it white. So you can crop these as well, but you can see there's a ton of them. Look at all this stuff. Like there's another one there with the moose. There's this one here. You can just crop them out. Look at all these Christmas sweater designs that you can have on Canva. The list goes on and on as you scroll. There are some that are by themselves that you don't have to do, but I can't find them right now. I found them before. Like I said, Canva just has so many that it's hard to find, but you could easily crop some of these out, right? And let me show you. Do with the crop tool. Say you want that one. You know, come in here. Crop this guy out. Now you may have to get some of these in here to fit, and that's fine. And then use that as your sweater. Change it to white, of course. All of these can be changed easily to white. And then do a search. Like there's tons, like I said. So you might have to refine your search or look one just for a deer. And or some may surprise you. You come in here and hit magic recommendations and find it. But because there's so many, when you do find it, make sure you star it so that you can find it again. Because like me, I can't find it again. I probably should have starred that deer when I found it the first time. So there you go. This is mine. Let's get rid of this. So this is one design that I did, but you can see there's so many graphics, so many things on Canva that you can do this over and over again. Of course, changing the words, changing what's in here. Maybe do one for dogs, do one for cats, do one for dinosaurs, do one for different things, right? It doesn't just have to have this phrase. Come up with some funny phrase. and there's tons of them out there. Make your own. Don't copy this one exactly. You're gonna have to make your own designs, but you can use these elements, right? Use these borders and these things in your designs and have fun with this. And hopefully get a lot of sales this Christmas. I know a lot of people are doing this. And even if you don't get sales this Christmas, if you put a lot of them, I know it's kind of late to get Christmas sales, holiday sales, but this can be ongoing for next year and next year. That's the great thing about print on demand. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. You can see there's tons of graphics that you can use on Canva to make your own Christmas, ugly Christmas sweaters, and you can make a ton of them. So scale this idea. That's what I would suggest, is to make a ton of them, not just one, make a bunch of them for this holiday season and holiday seasons in the future. If this video is really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, have you seen ugly Christmas sweater design t-shirts before? If you have, let me know where. If you have one, let me know that as well. Leave that in the comments. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more design tutorials, click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.